Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please welcome your host, the man who makes Des O'Connor look like a wrinkly brown singer who presents a chat show. It's Barry Gibson.
Thank you, Sandy, you cross-dresser. That's right, I'm Barry Gibson, and welcome to Whatever I Want, the challenge show in which you, the general public, are the viewer. And tonight, it's the last show in the present series. Anyway, we'll be putting focus on the Homes and Gardens programme. That's right, Ground Force, Housebusters,
Hot Property,
Changing Rooms,
Real Rooms,
Charlie's Garden Army,
and Change That.
Sandy, you've got a garden, haven't you? You've got a garden outside your homo. Oh, you do, don't you? And you like flowers. You like pansies, don't you? You like their gay colours, don't you? Isn't your garden uphill? You're an uphill gardener, and all your pretty flowers, their stalks are bent that way.
The answer to all those questions is no. I live on the fourth floor, which has no garden.
Oh.
I am, however, bisexual.
What? Animals? That's disgusting.
Coming up on tonight's Whatever I Want, Barry answers an elderly viewer's DIY prayers with Mandy Smith and a tower block lift, Keith Lemon goes green in his very own remakeover of The Exorcist, and autograph hunter Avid Merrion will be on the trail of another celebrity.
That bloozer, Keith Lemon here. Now, home improvement can be a very successful thing. My mum used to say to me, Keith, a home is a home, 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 is a home. Quite literally. And she was right, but not in this case. This house in front of me belongs to Jeff and Gaynor Breakspear, and today they've spent over 20 grand on home improvements, and still they're unhappy with the feel of the place and the look of the place. So let's find out why.
Hello, love. Is your mum or dad in?
Righto, Jeff Gaynor, specifically, what is wrong with the house? I've heard you've spent 20 grand, so what's going on?
Yes, we're very happy with the place. We just a few things that we need to sort out, mainly the girl's room.
OK, well, I'll tell you what, I might wizard a bob with home improvement, except I'm not Australian and I'm not the only wizard. But let's see what I can do then. Lead the way, loser. Oh, I can see your problem. Oh, dear. I tell you what, give it about half an hour. I've got my work cut out here, but I'll see what I can do for you. Loser. Righto, Jeff and Gaynor, I've done. Do you want to come and have a look? Yeah. You see what I've done? A red lampshade to go with your red complex Norio. Loser. What do you think? Nice, isn't it?
Hello, Avid Merrion here again, foremost professional autograph hunter with collection bigger than my fat batty. Do you know, though, I do get very tired of people thinking I am a stalker. I don't use hammers to do stalking because I don't even do stalking. I'm collecting autographs on objects which are relevant to the personality. But yes, I get tediously fucked off out of my head with boredom. So today, I'm having happiness with operation game, putting bones in, taking bones out, watching his nose go, ape! It is great magical fun. But the object today for you to guess who the celebrity is on this CD record. It is Madonna, Ray of Light. So can you guess who it is? Don't think it is Madonna because that is too easy, you foolish pig dog.
Now, do you know, I receive thousands of letters each week from our viewers, people asking me to help them. Barry, can you help me build a scout hut? Barry, can you help me raise some money? Barry, can you help me find the lost treasure of the Aztec kings? And of course, I reply, I say, no, I can't help you. Bugger off. Who do you think I am, Mother Teresa? Honestly, commoners. The other day, though, I received this letter from a Mr. Brian Cox of London. Now, he had a very peculiar problem, and whenever I hear of anybody with a peculiar problem, there's only one person I can call. That's right, stylish telly lady from Wish You Were Here and GMTV, Miss Cleo Rocos. Welcome to Whatever I Want, Cleo.
Thank you for having me, Barry.
It's nice to have you. OK, 90% of the time we challenge our guests with a Whatever I Want challenge. So why don't you choose a challenge from one of these golden telly envelopes? Read it out. I must remind you, though, when you do the challenge, you'll be helped by my co-presenter. That is, if you accept. Read it out.
Your challenge, should you accept it, is to bring a bit of British countryside into a busy city centre.
Do you accept? She does! Brilliant! We've got a Whatever I Want challenge. Yes!
Bluesy! Keith Lemon here, and I'm stood with my favourite piece of telly pie, Cleo Rocos. Now, let me remind you of your challenge. It was to bring a bit of countryside into the city.
That's
more
right.
Specifically, we got Gibson. Was it Gibson? Gibson got a letter from a man called Brian Cox, who is the directing manager of a very busy textile company. And here he is. Brian, how busy are you?
I'm very busy.
And I bet you're tired of the concrete jungle, and you'd like us to bring a bit of jungle of the countryside into your life.
Yes, I would.
Okay, then why don't you sit down there on that stupid little crate with your eyes shut, no peekaboo, until we finish, and then we'll sort you out, all right?
Right.
Off you go, then. Bruiser on toast. Let's go, Cleo. Actually, love, what I'm thinking is spending hours metamorphosizing this factory into an urban oasis. But on the other hand, get loads of grass and leaves and shit and bung it in one of his vans. What do you think?
I think we should at
you
least
took the words right out of my mouth. Come on, I'll stick some in your mouth. I've not taken words out of my mouth. Smell that cunty air. Fill your lungs clear. Now the finest turf comes from meadows grown on rich river silt. Our turf on the other hand is coming from a bloke on the market. So clear, keep him talking, keep him occupied. I thought help.
Fruit, I need some fruit, lots of fruit, something tropical. Have you got some
pineapples?
Lovely, lots of excellent.
Oranges.
Oh, wonderful. Have you been on holiday recently?
Yes.
So, how long have you been in the industry?
40 years.
Fruit industry. 40 years.
Cleo, run!
Bye!
Well, there we go. The van's full of the countryside. Just one finishing touch. A piece of shit. Right, Cleo, bring Brian in.
Brian.
Keep your eyes shut, Brian. Are you ready to experience the experience? Then get inside the van. Come on, Shaw. You're going to love this, Brian. Brian, can you feel that country grass under your feet? What a treat. What about some country air? And what's fresher than country air? An air freshener. Cleo, air freshener. Country air. Brian, you're going to love this stink. It smells beautiful, just like the country. And now, Brian, feel the swaying of the giant redwood, majestically swaying in the air breeze. Cleo, swaying branches. That's not a branch, it's a tube.
Brian, look. A rare glimpse of the monarch of the glen, the magnificent creature! Don't see that in a bloody city!
Patoos! And then, Brian, perhaps a little rainfall. Unfortunately, we forgot to bring the hose pipe, so I'm having to use my own man water. Can you feel it, Brian? Come in, Joe. Oh, it's a river! It's a lake! Oh.
Then, as it will, Brian, night must fall, and out come those nocturnal creatures, the local savage lunatic!
Where now, Billy? I'll kill that bird of it! Where is it? I'll kill that peregrine falcon!
Rocos! I'll kill it!
Okay, recap. The autograph I want is going to be on this object relevant to the person. It is Madonna CD, Ray of Light. You may be liking Madonna. I also like Madonna, but I also like Tom and Jerry. But I like it so much, I have to ration myself to one frame a week. This one is bloody brilliant. Fucking love it. Loser, what marvellous fun we had. And because she was successful in her challenge, Cleo received a specially crafted whatever that want trophy.
Oh, I'm touched, Keith.
Are you? I'm such a lady. You got anything you want to say?
Well, I just... Loser,
like less to... about you. I'll tell you what, I'm going to tools on back of you.
Is there anyone there? I want to come out, please.
Wasn't Cleo brilliant? She really threw herself into it. Now, as always, on whatever I want, I've got to do what they normally do, got to do their job. However, Cleo wasn't working today. She was having the day off to see her mum. So I've come to see her mum. Hello, Cleo's mum. Can I just call you mum? Brilliant. Haven't seen you for a long time. It's a bit warm, isn't it? Yes. Now, how much do you love me, mummy? Tell me you love me. Can you lend me some money? Otherwise, I'll just steal it anyway, like I used to do. Remember, and you told me off and spanked my bum. I know. Do you want to meet my girlfriend? She's in the bag. I'll get her out for you. Here, Mel. Isn't she beautiful? Can you remember her from the telly? Mel, I'm surprised at you. Shake her hand. Shake her hand. Stop staring at her. She can't help being famous. Shake her hand. She's beautiful. Say hello, Melanie. Oh, look at the time. It's past my bedtime. That's disgusting. You've been naughty, Mum. You should have put me to bed. Honestly, I'm going to put myself to bed and then you come in and tuck me in and read me a story. Mum, I'm ready. Tuck me in. I love it when you tuck me in. Don't do it too tight. It's too tight. It's better. Join me in part two when I'll be solving a viewer's dinner party dilemma with some paint, some glitter, and a stick with some shit on the end of it. Stop it, you. Right, I'm ready for the story. Timmy the one-eared bat.
Timmy the one-eared bat loved his bicycle very, very much.
Okay, your time is up. No more guessing. This is the answer to the clue, which is a Madonna Ray of Light CD. The person I am stuck waiting for, the relevance is this. This song is singing this. I'm a free all, like I just got home. I'm a free all. That is right. It is I'm a free all I am stuck waiting for. Did you guess? Did you fuckers guess? You could not guess a piss in the fucking wind. Shut up.
Right, for Barry Gibson's table centrepiece, you will need a selection of glitters, some gold spray paint, a magic tree, and of course, a stick with some shit on the end. So there we have it, the Barry Gibson table centrepiece. It is bloody beautiful. Barbara, what do you think?
It's horrible.
No, but you'll grow to like it now, won't you?
No.
Drop that up. Anyone for soup?
Look at him, you little pink one. With your neck, which is very long, wrinkly, and little smile. How do you smile at me? I don't know how you do it. It's very good. I'm liking it.
Hello. I don't need to tell you who I am. You know I'm Avid Merrion, an autograph hunter. And every time you are interrupting me while I'm playing with myself, and I'm not speaking of my tiny prick, you sick, dirty mind. I'm speaking of my talking E.T., who for him, it is not good to talk, it is essential, so he can get wedge packet from BT Phone Company. And he's saying now, speak it, alien bastard!
Alien.
It is impressive, isn't it? But do you know, stalker. Lots of people say I'm a stalker. I'm not a stalker. Do I look like a man who has nothing better to do with his life than to prowl behind celebrities and with these nunchuckers? Resulting in them fearing their life more than a bastard slug? Shut the fuck off! Go away out of my life! But not yet, though. First, I want you to guess who it is I'm stalking, waiting for, by the object which is relevant to them, which I want them to sign. It is this. It is a chicken coop full of ladies' panties. Ladies' panties! I like ladies' panties, too! Can you guess who it is? Shut up. Loser, Keith Lemon here. Now, you know what I've always thought? Lifts are pretty much like women. We go in them, we go up them, we go down on them, and then we come out of them pretty sharpish and bugger off. But another problem with lifts, again like women, nobody's got any respect for them, apart from one little old lady who loves her lift. I'm talking about 126-year-old Hattie Langstaff. Hattie. Now, Hattie can't use a leg, so she can't use the stairs. So she's grown to love a lift in a non-sexual way, of course. So, Hattie, what's the problem with your lift?
Oh, it's awful, Keith. There's nothing right with it, is there?
I know you could write your crapper on here, nobody noticed, would it? It's terrible. Well, I tell you what, I believe this lift should be made more prettier, a beautiful place, a lift you're proud of going up in.
Oh, I agree with that.
You ready for that, then?
I spend a lot of time in it.
Right, I tell you what, we could have got Carol Smiley. But I think she's past it myself. Do you know what I mean? So I think we're going to go for someone a bit younger, somebody a bit fitter. I'm talking about one of my old flames. I'm talking about Mandy Smith. Mandy Smith, come in.
How are you?
I'm all right.
Kate, enough, Kate. You've always got another woman.
This is Hattie.
Hattie, how are you?
Hello, this is Mandy.
Hello.
Now, Mandy, it's you do a bit of DIY yourself, don't you?
Yeah, I do, actually, but
I like a man around as well.
You like to do it yourself?
Keith, no, I said...
Not many ladies admit that, do they? I love a lady who gets her fingers dirty. Stop her with the loser. So what about the lift? What do you think, Mandy?
I think it's awful. I think it's horrible.
I think we need to spruce it up, make it a bit brighter.
Hattie, you poor thing, it's a dump in here.
Well, I tell you what, there's no time to lose, so let's not wait. Let's get the tools and get the paint. That standard up there, can you just tell me how much it is, please? I'll come back then, yeah?
No,
thanks for your help. Well, here I am back in the lift. And as my old spy Mike Leigh used to say, get, go! Done a mighty fine job, Mandy. Congrats. But what I'm particularly fond of is the touch that I brought to the lift. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We asked a group of local school children to draw some pictures to brighten up the place. Of course, they couldn't be asked. So we got the next best thing, a group of loonies from the local psychiatrist called the Loony Bin. Beautiful. Are you still guessing who it is? Well, now there is a clue as big as the teeth in Don French's over-the-shoulder boulder holder. I am now taking the panties out of the cage. Can you guess who it is? Then shut up! Now! Oh, Mandy, you've really done a good job. That is beautiful. Fit for the queen. Unfortunately, we've only got a dippy-nosed lady, so go get her. Oh, Blue, go get Hattie. Oh, get up and get the blindfold on. Oh, so excited. Incredible, the big moment has come. Are you excited, Hattie?
Oh, I am excited. I'm longing to see it.
Mandy's done a blues job. This is proper Sally, Mandy. Incredible. Right, Hattie, go in. Tell us what you think of it. I think you're going to love it. It's incredible. Tell you what, later on, me and you could go tools on the pastor, eh? Can't it? Christ! Oh, it's like that bit out of Rosanna, isn't it? Thank you. By now, you're probably excited as me because I think you are getting warm. Because I'm making it more obvious as I go along for your thick mind. I am taking the knickers from out of the cage until there is nothing in the cage. No knickers in this cage. It is a Nicholas cage. It is relevant to the person I am waiting for. I said his fucking name! It is Nicholas Cage, the scruffy slapper from Hollywood! Did you get it? Well, don't look so proud. You still look overweight to me. Shut up. Fuck. Shut up. Fuck off! Fuck off now! Goodbye. Oh, charming. Well, as a result of Hattie the old lady falling down the lift chute and plummeting to her death, Mandy Smith doesn't receive a Whatever I Want trophy. But what a good sport she was. Anyhow, it's now that time in the show where I do what our challengee would normally be doing, that being Mandy. But because it's the last show in the present series, I really am going to do Whatever I Want. I'm going to stay in, share pizza and carnation with two top telly babes. I know what you're thinking, my loyal telly viewers. Barry Gibson with two top telly babes? That's just not possible. Well, eat your words, bitch. You thought there'd be no telly birds. Look at me with Sherry Kaywood and Kate Thornton. All you that went to school with me, look at me now. Where are you? At home with your girlfriend, pregnant with six children? Go pack fish. Give us a carnation if you want. You toss me off if you want.
All right then, Barry.